I lecture on a module called CS252. Everybody now calls it C++. I think of it as interactive web programming. And this involves doing HTML5 and JavaScript and stuff like that. And to refresh my memory, having taught it last year, this year I thought I'd make myself a little game in order to revise the stuff. When you're writing a game, there's a couple of things you want to think about. You want to think about the type of game you want to have. You want to think about the kinds of interaction. You want to think about target audience and that kind of thing. So I decided to do a basic shooter type game. So you've got targets which move across the screen. You've got a gun which you can move around and you can shoot the targets with. Most of the targets are going to give you some points, but a couple of targets are going to take away points. So you've got to hit the baddies, not hit the goodies. And that's the basic game mechanics. An exceptionally basic HTML5 game. But I think it's important to think about the audience. My target audience are small boys. This is my nephew Stanley. I've got five nephews and grandson. Who are all small boys at the moment. And the small boys are interested in different things to large boys, but kind of. And what small boys really like, from what I can work out, is they like trains, they like dinosaurs, they like explosions, and they like anything to do with going to the toilet.
That's not small boys, that's just boys.
Okay, so having done my market research on the target audience, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Pooh Bum Dinosaur Train Explosion. This is HTML5 game based around click location. You might have noticed.
Oh, my God. He's as good as he sounds.
And what you've got to do is kill the dinosaurs but not kill the train because that's bringing the supplies. You'll notice there's a QR code on my slides. If you follow that QR code, you get to play the game yourself. And one of the nice things about it that I've been working on most recently is interactivity using the tilt sensor. So you can play it on a mobile device. So it's got different types of controls. You can play with the keyboard like I was just doing there. It's got mouse functionality so you can do clicks to poo, and there's also using the gyro, so if you're on a mobile device, tilting the device should make the bum move backwards and forwards across the top of the screen and you can tap to poo. So it's kind of a basic game, there's some problems with it, but I thought I'd just show it on because it's kind of funny. It's a bit laggy, particularly on devices with little memory. The mobile controls are blanking to say the least, so the drivers work different ways, depending upon which way you're holding your device, obviously. But sometimes you tilt it instead of going down, the bum goes up, so it's like a floating bum rather than a simple bum. But you know, tap also selects, so it's a bit funny. You can't disable screen rotation from within the browser. I'm kind of surprised to find you can access the gyroscopes from within the browser. But you can do gyroscopes and accelerometers from inside the browser. I'm probably going to have to detect what kind of device people are using and have different controls based on that, which is always a pain, but there you go. So it's not finished, it's half baked, and that's exactly what the show and tell's for. There you go. That's my talk. Pooh Bum Dinosaur. Hey.
People who play this game vulnerable to impaired domestic conversation. Could you clarify the question?
Matthew has a question.
Do you think that HTML5 has potential in gaming compared to say Flash?
Yeah, I do.
Do you think it's there yet?
I think it's getting there. I think that the coursework from my recent module, some of the authors of which are in the audience, are considerably better than Pooh Bum Dinosaur Train Explosion. and show you that it's got quite a lot of capabilities to do some very cool stuff. So, I think HTML5 is coming along nicely. And that's that. So, who's next? Colin.